वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडेज टॉपिक इज डिजाइन ऑफ नकल जॉइंट. लास्ट टाइम वी हैव सीन डिजाइन ऑफ क्वार्टर जॉइंट. नाउ नकल जॉइंट इज ऑल्सो वन मोर टाइप ऑफ रॉड जॉइंट एंड वी आर गोइंग टू सी हाउ दिस इज डिजाइंड. यू विल फाइंड सम ऑफ द फीचर्स आर सिमिलर टू लास्ट टाइम इन द सेंस दैट द टू रॉड्स आर कमिंग फ्रॉम टू एंड्स एंड दिस टू रॉड्स वी वॉन्ट टू जॉइन देम. So for the purpose of joining, last time we saw that there was a socket and spigot arrangement with a cotter. So that was the way it was connected and tied to each other, let us say. Now here again there are two rods and these two rods you are going to tie to each other. But this time we are going to make use of a joint called as a knuckle joint. The difference here is that the pin here is a cylindrical pin. Last time cotter was a pin. And that pin was having a rectangular section. As a result, in the last example, the joint that was formed, that joint was not having any kind of a rotary movement. Now that is not the case here because there is a pin joint. Therefore, this joint, now this is the front view, this is the top view. So in the top view, you can see that this can perform a rotation like this because the pin is there, which is a cylindrical pin here. So that is why the joint is slightly different than last time. And as a result, the components also are to be maybe slightly different they are, and accordingly we have to design them. Now another thing what we are going to learn in today's exercise as compared to the last time is that we are going to do the design work in a slightly different way. What we are going to do is we are going to do this by making use of something that is called a standard formula. 1 minute. So here what we are going to do is we are going to make use of what is called as empirical relations. So I'll just write here. Empirical equations means what? Now here we are going to make use of certain equations, certain relations, certain formulae, you can say, which are based on certain observations, and we are going to make use of them for the purpose of designing. Now let us see how it is. Instead of defining and explaining, as we go further ahead, we will come to know what are these empirical equations. So this is the exercise, and it is having, there are two rods, and these rods are experiencing a load like this P. So you have applied a tensile load on this rod like this, and then under this condition the different parts of the rod or different parts of the joint, they are under some kind of stress. Accordingly we are going to design them. So let's first maybe name the which are the parts which are there. So on the right side, this part which is there, this has got a single eye end, so this is called as a single eye end. This rod is called as single eye end. And the other side, what you see, something like a fork. So this has got similar eye, but there are two eyes, so this is called as a double eye end. So single eye, then there is double eye, then here there is a pin. There is a pin. Here what you see here is a collar. And here there is a lock pin. What is shown here is a lock pin. Now this lock pin is to be shown here also, which is not yet shown. So this I will show maybe something like this. This pin will go till the body of the collar which is here. So when you draw from top, it will be seen maybe a dotted like this. Then it will be round like this, then it will go inside inside till here. Then the two ends will be flared like this. Okay, so I just show the pin, lock pin which is here, and then collar, then double iron and single iron and the main pin. So these are the different five parts are there which we are going to design. Now when we start, we have already written empirical equations. So what it says is, first we start with a normal design. So I'll just call this as a single iron end. So design of single iron end, we start with design of single I end. At least this part, okay. So you will see here that the load applied is P, and because of this load, this rod end of the single I end, this rod might fail, and the failure will be in the form of a tensile stress. So I'll write here tensile failure of rod of single I end. So we are considering the tensile failure of single I end. For that, as you can see here, the equation is FT design. That means design tensile stress is equal to load upon area, where load is P and the area of this cross section is pi d square by 4. So this is going to give you, I'll write here, find diameter D, and the resisting area is like this. So this is the diameter D. So this diameter D is here, it is under tensile stress, and the resisting area is pi d square by 4. Load upon pi d square by 4 is equal to design tensile stress, which is given in this equation for the exercise. And because of that, you will be able to find out what is going to be the diameter D. And as you already have seen, you are supposed to do it the rounding and get the final size, which is suitable size for the diameter D. Now, once this part is done, now the next part we are going to make use of empirical relations. Now what it says is, once you find out one dimension D, then all the remaining dimensions, whatever dimensions are shown here, all these dimensions, they are now going to be found out in terms of D. So you know D. So using this value of D, you have got some numerical value of D. Let us say you got D as, let's say, 30 mm. So once you get D as 30 mm, then the other dimensions are obtained by making use of this 30 mm size of D, by making use of empirical relations. So I'll first write these empirical relations, and then we will go further ahead to see this different method. So I'll write here empirical relations. Now let D1 is equal to D. That means this pin diameter which is there, which is called as D1. So this D1 is to be taken same as D. D1 is same as D. Okay. Then next is D2. D2 is taken as 2 times D. D3 is taken as 1.5 times D. Then there is a T. T is taken as 1.25 times D. T1, we'll see this one by one. T1 is 0.75 D. Then there is T2. Is 0.5. T2 is 0.5 times D. And then there is one more size, that is diameter of pin, DP. This is a DP. So diameter of pin, DP, is taken as 0.3 times T2. So at this stage, what you can see is, here now what you can see is, all the dimensions which are required, these dimensions, they are written in the form of some kind of a formula. And this formula says that the dimensions are shown in terms of D. The dimensions, all the dimensions, they are shown in terms of D. Even some of the dimensions which I have not written here, they are already shown here. Take this as 4 times D. Take this as 4.5 times D. Take this as 0.6 times D, this radius. Then take this radius as 1.2 times D. That means you will find that at this stage, once you find out D by normal calculations using stress equation, then all the dimensions are now available. and once they are available, as such the drawing can be drawn and as such the work is over, because the design is over in the sense that we have got all the dimensions. Once the dimensions are there, that means the design is over, because now you can make these parts. Last time what happened, the dimensions were not there. So what we have done, we have found out the failure criteria for each and every place. We have applied a suitable equation at each place, sometimes shear stress, sometimes tensile stress, sometimes compressive stress, sometimes bearing stress and so on. And then accordingly we have started finding out each dimension one by one. Now here the dimensions are already available in the form of standard equations, empirical equations. So does this mean that the work is really over? We have got all the dimensions and the work is over. Is it like this? The answer is no. Here, although we have got the dimensions, we are not yet knowing whether the various parts or various dimensions what we obtained, are they safe or not. For example, we have decided the diameter of the pin, that is D1, this D1 to be taken same as D. So whatever D you have found out, take D1 same, that is what the empirical relation says. But then, as you know, this pin, now I'll just show you, this is the pin and this pin is fitted between the two ends like this. And now under the load, this pin will fail at two places, that is called as a shear failure. So this pin is going to fail from here and here because of shear stress. Okay, if the design is not proper. So now our job is to check, see, not design, check. Our job is to check whether the dimensions what you have obtained, are they sufficient so that the shear failure for the pin will not take place. That means, now we will write equation here, again design equation. Just like this design equation, we will write different design equations where stress is equal to load upon area. But then, load is known, area in this case is already known because the dimensions are there. So load upon area is stress. So the stress which you are going to find out, that is the stress which is induced stress. With these dimensions, the stresses should be created. And whatever stresses are created, those stresses we are going to check whether they are less than the design stresses or not. If they are less than the design stresses, that means the particular type of failure will not take place. Now that we will see one by one. So now next thing is, we are talking about still the same thing, single iron. Now this single iron will not fail from here now because we have designed. Now from where else it will fail? Now you will find here that this is a single iron whose shape is like this, then it has got a circular shape and with that there is one hole here. So if you see the failure of this particular part, I'll just draw it here again. It will have a shape something like this. And here there is a hole for the pin. And you are applying a load. Now what will happen is, it will fail at one place by the tensile stress. So if you think this is the place from where it will break into two parts if the size is not sufficient. Okay. So this area is going to resist the tensile failure. If the design is correct, then it will not happen. So now let's write, I'll write here the second part. Tensile failure of single iron across the tensile failure of single iron itself. That means this single iron which is there, it will fail because of tensile load, and in that case it will fail from here. So what we do is, we write the design equation Ft equal to, now this is going to be induced stress. I am writing induced instead of design. I am writing IND, induced. So IND is equal to load upon area. Now what is the area here it's going to be? If you see the other view is like this. Like this. That means it is failing from here. The thickness is T. So I'll just show how it looks like. I'm just drawing slightly bigger diagram to look something like this. and then since it has failed, so this is the newly created area here. So it's the same section as shown here, and the thickness is T, the diameter is inside diameter, this was D, is the diameter of the pin, and the outside diameter was D2, this was D1 rather, pin diameter is D1. So whole diameter is D1, the outside diameter is D2. So D2 and D1, they are the two diameters. We can show even here also. This is D2 and this is D1. And the thickness is T. So this is the resisting area which is going to resist the failure. So what is this area going to be? So D2 minus D1 into T. Now when you say D2 minus D1, we are taking the length, this as well as this, both sides. So you don't have to do again, multiply by 2 is not required here. D2 is this much, from this much you minus, reduce this much. So what is remaining is this plus this, this and this. So that is one dimension, the other dimension is T. So D2 minus D1 into T, that is the resisting area, which I'll write here, D2 minus D1 multiplied by T, this is the resisting area. Now as you see here, it is the resisting area here. As you see, D2, D1, T, everything is known. All the dimensions here are known. Now this time we are going to use a design equation where the load and dimensions are already known. Last time here, if you see, dimensions were not known. We found out the dimensions where the stresses are taken at design stress. Now here, load is there, dimensions are there. So the stress which is found out, now after doing this calculation, you will get the value of a stress. That stress is called as induced stress. The stress that is at the moment with this dimensions, whatever stress is going to be here, that is this much. And this stress you want to see whether it is less than the given tensile design stress. So you are given initially here, you are given the value of P, maybe say 30 kilonewtons, and then FT design 80 megapascals, and this Newton per mm square. So with this data you are going to design, so you know what is the value of tensile design stress. So if this induced stress is less than design stress, that means whatever stress is at the moment there is less than what is allowed, and therefore this will not happen. So this is safe. So once this is the value is less, then you can say safe. Okay, the dimension is safe, or the tensile or the signal end is safe for this kind of a failure. Okay, so one more factor we have checked, what will happen if it is to fail from here. Now there are some other ways of failure also there, which we will see them one by one. First we started with failure from here and obtained a diameter D. Then we have got all the empirical relations, we got all the dimensions. Then we started with the next parameter, that is the tensile failure at this place with the dimensions available, so that we have found out this time induced stress, and that induced stress we checked. This time we checked whether it is less than the design stress or not. And if it is less, then we say it is okay. So you can write here, when you actually do the calculations, get the answer, and if you find it less than 80, then you say design is safe. Okay, now let's see the next part. So now the next is shear failure of single failure of shear end. Shear failure of single end. Now this single end, I'll draw again. This will also fail in shear. So this is the end, and when you pull it like this, then there is a chance that it might get sheared off from here like this. It might get sheared off from here when you apply load. Now this failure we want to prevent, and for that we write similar equation saying that if shear induced is equal to load upon resisting area here. Now, how do you find out the resisting area here? That is important. This is diameter D2 and the inside is the diameter D1. Now, this area is slightly difficult to find out how much it will be, because there is a curvature here, it will end here, starting from here, ending here. So, if you see this as a radius, then this is D2 by 2 if you think like this. But then there is slightly less. It is not exactly D2 by 2, it is less than D2 by 2. So, here what is done is, to get the very simple equation, what is done is, we are thinking of this length to be on the safer side. The length which is from here to here, which is definitely less than this length. This length is much more, this is less. Okay, but we decide to take this length for the purpose of resisting area, although it is not really going to fail from here. We are thinking about failing from here at two places. But for getting the exact, for getting the value of the resisting area, we are assuming that to let us take the area this two times, because this area is less. When you take, we have to take it two times. Whatever area you are going to take is anyway going to be less than what is the actual area. So we are on the safer side. Whatever value, whatever induced stress we are going to find out, that will be, whatever we are finding, that will be more than what is actually there. So even if it is more, if it is still less than the given stress, then the actual will be definitely safe. Therefore, we are selecting slightly worst area, which is this area. And how much is this area going to be? This area is going to be D2 minus D1, which is easy to find out. So we have decided this is D2 minus D1 into the thickness, which is T. And then you have to take it two times. Now two times is not required here, because this is D2 minus D1, and then that is, once you say D2 minus D1, then it is this length, this and this, and anyway you want it on this and this two sides. So this is already containing two times, so we want one on this side, one on this side, so this is fine. So now that we will write here, D2 minus D1, and then make it multiplied by T. So this becomes your shear stress induced, which should be less than the shear stress design. If it is so, then it is okay. This kind of failure will not take place. Okay. Now the next is, from where else it will fail? Now again you will see there is a pin, it is like this, and when the load is applied, that time between the pin and the curvature of the hole, there is going to be a stress at the contact point here. At this